So I'm doing a very belated July wrap-up that is like before BookTubeathon. And if you want to see what I read during BookTubeathon, you could watch my vlog. But the first book that I read in July was Every Heart a Doorway by Seanan McGuire, which feels like I read it 6 months ago. But this is a young adult fantasy novella about these children in a boarding school who have gone to different portal worlds and have trouble adjusting to the real world. And I thought that whole concept was really interesting, but then they threw in this whole murder mystery thing, which I'm normally into, but it really took it down. And I did not like the ending. But I am curious. I know that Seanan McGuire is going to have a series of these novellas about the different portal worlds, so I'm definitely interested in reading the next one. But yeah, overall it was just okay. I feel like it could have been a lot better, but I like the concept as a whole, so. And then I read a poetry book called I Love It Though by Allie Warren, and she is a San Francisco Bay Area poet. And I read her first collection, Here Comes the Warm Jets, and then this is her most recent one. I really enjoy the cover a lot, and it's like bright pink on the back. This was good. Her poetry is like not normally my style. It's very like smart sounding, if that makes sense. Like, she uses a lot of big words, and it's not very rhythmic, but it's very like stimulating. So you can't read them really quickly, which is how a lot of people read poems and poetry collections. This one you kind of have to take your time with it, but if you do, it's definitely worth it. There's some really good gems in here. And then I read a book that I've been trying to read for years. It's Tender Morsels by Margot Lanigan. And this is it is not a young adult book. It's classified as young adult in America, but as adult everywhere else. And yeah, it's not a young adult book. There's a lot of discussions online about that. So if you're curious, you could look it up. But this is about this woman named Liga, who is living a very difficult and upsetting life. And basically, Earth like creates a portal to like a fantasy land for her to live in to escape the harshness of reality. And so she has two daughters, one who's like more sweet and calm, and one who's more like curious and brash. And they live in this world, and slowly, kind of, the walls between the reality world and the fantasy world that they're living start to kind of crumble, and things start coming through, and they start going back to the real world. I thought it was really, really great. I really love dark fairy tales. I think this is a retelling of something. It's like a loose retelling of what is it called? Rose Red and Snow White, but it's like the original, and it's very different. But I liked this a lot. It was good. It was dark, but like I've read darker stuff. If you are young, maybe check out what's in this before you dive into it. Because there's some disturbing things described in here. But I like this a lot, and it's one of my new favorites, so definitely one of my favorite books that I read this year. And the next book I read was Love Letter by Angie Briski. I think that's how you say her last name. I do know in real life, so I should probably know that, but I just call her Angie. And this is actually a zine. It's a collection of typewritten love letters that she posted in the Free SF Weekly. And so it's just kind of a collection of all of the love letters that she wrote, and then pictures of the SF Weekly, like, boxes. I liked it. It was really cute. I don't really read, like, romantic things. I mean, they're not all super romantic. Some of them are a little sad. They're kind of, like, based off of those, like, love letters and misconnections you'd find in the newspaper, like, on Craigslist, so. One thing is, it's very small font, so if you have trouble reading, I'm not sure if they have an e-version, but that might be a little better for you. Not if you have trouble reading. If you have trouble reading small font, this might be a little difficult, but I will check if there is an e-version of this. I don't think there is, because it is a zine, but she does have an ISBN and Library of Congress number, which the zines sometimes don't have, so there might be a digital version of this that you can check out some of the poems. And then the last book that I read in July that was not part of Booktubeathon was Everything is Flammable by Gabrielle Bell. And this is a graphic novel. I had never heard of this artist before, but I guess she's, like, pretty popular. She does a lot of, like, creative, nonfiction, diary sort of works. And this one is about her returning to her childhood home in Northern California, which is kind of weird because it's very similar to where a lot of my family lives and where I live for part of my life. That was a little freaky. But yeah, she returns there after her family home is destroyed by a fire, and her mother, who she kind of has a strange relationship with, is trying to, like, rebuild her home. And kind of the tensions between the mother and her daughter, and just the connection, and also attempts to, like, pull away from her childhood and that whole world. It was great. It was, like, it made me cry at the end, but it really affected me because, like, I've been there, like, I've been where she is for most of the book, and, like, I have family there, and, like, I know that world, and it's, like, yeah. I have similar feelings to her about returning there. But it was really great. The art is just a very, like, realistic style, but it has a lot of, like, cool shadows and stuff. And they're all just, like, little snippets. Like, most of them are just a page long, so, like, that's the title of it, and then it's that page. Some of them are a little longer, but it's just little snippets about her and her mom, and yeah. I liked this a lot, and I definitely want to check out some of her other stuff, because I know this is, like, a pretty large one. I mean, it's not long, but it's a collection, so yeah, I would like to check out some more of hers. And yeah, I know that was kind of short, but those are the books that I read in July that were not part of the Booktubeathon. Yeah, I had a pretty busy month, so I mostly read a lot of comics, but this August is busy, but I will have time to read, hopefully. I am trying to participate in Tome Topple. So far, I've actually already read one tome, so I read Cages by Dave McKeon, which fulfilled the, like, read a graphic novel challenge, but that readathon, I think it was started August 4th, and that is 2 weeks, so that's pretty long. So I just started a 500-page novel, so I will be reading that for a while. But yeah, I'm hoping to just kind of go through a lot of the big books that I own. I read a lot of the teeny books I own for the Booktubeathon, so I'm hoping Tome Topple can help me challenge some of my bigger ones. But yeah. Let me know what you read in July, and if you participated in Booktubeathon, because I love watching people's vlogs for those, and their wrap-ups and stuff. It was a fun one. I didn't get to participate in any of the video or Instagram challenges, because it was a busy week, but if you did, let me know so I can check that out. And let me know if you're participating in Tome Topple, because that's a cool one, and I feel like because it's longer, there might be less people, and there also might not be as, like, much camaraderie since it's for 2 whole weeks, but, yeah, let me know, and I'll see you soon in another video. Bye!